Hart, what's going on?
I'm leaving.
Why? What did I do?
Not enough. The pressure is too much. I quit.
I get it.
I can do better. Just please, don't leave.
Don't let your heart quit on you. Get your uncontrolled high blood pressure to a healthy range before it's too late.
Focus Insight of the Southern University Ag Center. Welcome to another edition of Focus Insight on the Southern University Ag Center. I'm your host, Dexter Newman. And on today's show, we'll have Dr. Andre Johnson, Vice Chancellor for Research and Technology Development at the Southern University Ag Center. He'll be here to tell us about his latest projects and how they can help the community. The SU Ag Center hosted pet therapy sessions for students and faculty. We'll tell you why this is so important. Also, the Ag Center wants you to stay healthy, eat right, and exercise. It's all about a lifestyle change. We'll have all this and much more on this edition of Focus Insight on the Southern University Ag Center. Stay right there. We'll be back in just a moment. Welcome back. The SU Ag Center held its annual Small Farmer Conference at the F.G. Clark Activity Center in Baton Rouge. Small farmers from across the state were in attendance. Speakers, presentations, and networking opportunities. This is what attendees found at Southern University at the Louisiana Small Farmers Conference.
My wife and I, this is our second year to come to this conference, and we bought land, and Southern has given us a lot of opportunities and a lot of resources so we can start our small farm.
And we are here to learn information about grant writing and get some more knowledge of applying for grants, you know, for farming.
Randolph Joseph Jr., Assistant State Conservationist and Field Operations for NRCS, was the keynote speaker.
I felt obligated to come here today to work with small farmers, mainly let them know what the 2018 Farm Bill has to offer as far as small-scale farming. You know, it's our duties for rural America to try to reach these small farmers and keep them in business. And I felt obligated to come here today to spread the word about our conservation efforts here in Louisiana. The 2018 Farm Bill has made many changes that can better assist the small-scale farmers. My job, the job of NRCS, is to get that word out to the community so that they can become good stewards of the land.
A former Southern University Ag Leadership graduate returned to give back vital information to help small farmers thrive.
Southern's my adopted HBCU, my 1890. I wasn't fortunate enough to go to one, and I went through Southern's Ag Leadership Program. And I think it's important for folks like me who get knowledge about these programs to bring them back to, especially the farmers of color, because for so long, this information was withheld from us. So I feel it's an obligation and my way of giving back.
There was an assortment of vendors at the conference to offer their services to small farmers. One in particular was the Louisiana Market Maker.
We're here with the LSU Ag Center, and we're introducing the Louisiana Market Maker website to farmers who might be interested in selling retail. The beauty of this website is that anybody in the country can access a profile of a farmer and be able to read what the farmer has to sell. It's a great way for the farmer to be able to get word out about their project or their crop that they're growing, but also it's a great way for buyers to be able to see what's out there.
Reporting for the Southern University Ag Center, I'm Dexter Newman.
When most people hear the word agriculture, they may think about farming. Well, we'll be speaking with a Southern University College of Agriculture graduate who works in agriculture, and guess what? They're not farming. We'll have more on that when we return.
Today we have with us graduating senior from Southern University in the College of Agriculture, Malik Allen. Malik, as far as your years here at Southern University in the College of Agriculture, give us some of your experiences here at the university.
Well, I've had a lot of experiences.
I guess I'll start with my freshman year. My freshman year, I was just your traditional freshman. I wasn't really involved in school. I was just happy to be away from home. I wasn't really participating. I was going to class. I had a job, had my own car, so I was going to work, you know, doing things like that, just experiencing alone time away from my parents. But as I progressed, I started to get more and more into school. I started to get more active into the College of Ag. So between the end of my freshman year, my sophomore year, I met a couple guys, and they started helping me along the way. I started joining organizations. I started participating more and getting to know people inside the Department of Ag. So I guess the first organization I joined was the Urban Forestry Club. At that time, Joshua Simon, which is a guy, he's one of my closest friends now, he was the president of it. He reeled me in, and he tried to show me the ropes and show me the ways of the ag. After that, I started progressing. I started doing more. I ended up getting an on-campus job.
Yeah, we know what you're saying. Uh-huh.
On-campus job here at Southern University dealing with the garden. Then started developing my time. I joined an organization called Manners. That organization, I can absolutely say that it helped me the most.
Now, with Manners, the marketing side of that, don't you think that's a great deal for someone that's interested in maybe ag econ because of when they sell sweet potato sales that they have? Do you think that's pretty good for someone?
Oh, yeah, most definitely. So our annual sweet potato sale with the Manners organization is one of our biggest fundraisers. So in actuality, since I'm the ag econ major, I deal with the statistics side of it. So how many boxes we need, how many we need to sell to make a certain profit, differentials in the pounds, how many we need to, what box makes this amount of pounds, so things of that sort. So when it comes to economics, our economics majors here, whenever they join our Manners organization, they help out a lot when it comes to the sweet potato sales.
As far as ag econ, when you mention agriculture to someone, say high school students or those that's not in agriculture, I know when I've mentioned it, first thing to think about is farming. Give them a little bit more insight on that.
Okay, so I actually get this a lot. So I stated before I'm an ag econ major, so I actually deal nothing with animals, like hands-on. But the first thing whenever I tell someone, hey, I'm an ag econ major, they're like, oh, you deal with animals and you mess with cows. I'm like, not to that extent. I deal with the numbers of it. So how much does this cow sell for? What's the going price for the cow at this time and day? Things of that sort. But I'm a different type of student. I'm more versatile. So I do engage with the animals because that's the way I grew up. That's the stuff that I love. I do a lot of hands-on things just so I can be comfortable if I do need to do this for a real job. But there are a lot of different departments here. There's the plant soil science division. If you want to get into medicine, you gotta understand medicine comes from plants. Most of the medicine comes from plants. There's the agriculture economic side, the ag business side. There's animal science. There's the pre-vet organization. There's urban forestry. There's a lot of different routes you can take when it comes in agriculture.
Okay. I'm glad you explained that about agriculture, and there's so many different aspects to it. Now, someone that's interested in coming to Southern University, because that's where we want them here at Southern University in agriculture, what could you tell them to how they could get started and how soon you think they should get started?
Now, so when it comes here, as a student such as myself, this was the perfect fit for me. Just having a one-on-one time with my professors, I know the dean and the dean knows me on a first name basis. Things of that sort is a great aspect when it comes to coming to HBCU. You're not just a number.
Okay, and we understand that you have a job offer coming up real soon. Can you elaborate a little bit more about that, and how did you receive that job?
Yes, sir. So I actually received an offer, and I accepted the offer from a company called Land O'Lakes.
I know Land O'Lakes, the people that make butter. Yes, I know that from the grocery store.
Yes, sir. Yeah. So Land O'Lakes, they actually have three divisions. So there's Land O'Lakes, the butter, which everyone knows about. But then there's the sea portion, which is Winfield United. And then there's the grain portion of it, which is Purina. And I'm actually under the grain portion. I received the offer not too long ago, and I accepted it. And I actually got the opportunity based off of a conference that I went to. So I mentioned earlier about an organization called Manners. So we go on a lot of conferences and things of that sort so that we can get the internships and the jobs that we need. So,
and Malik, we wish you the best in your endeavors, and we're glad that you've made your way through Southern University, and we know that you have contributed quite a bit here. I've seen you around campus doing a lot outside of just agriculture. Yes. You've pitched in, and give our viewers an idea of what you presented to our chancellor earlier this year, a position that you volunteered and wanted to be a part of, let me say that much.
All right, so it's very simple. When it comes to creating a business, it's all about having a problem, selling a solution. So I noticed a problem when it came to, I guess, our recruiting aspect and things of that sort. So I sat down with the dean. I said, hey, this is what I've noticed. This is what I think we need to improve. I would like to be a part of that process. And, you know, he didn't say yes right off the bat. You know, we went back and forth and agreeing and disagreeing with each other and things of that sort. But in the end, it ended up working out, and we came on the same accord. I'm serving as the student engagement specialist. So I go out and recruit to high school students as well as pick up the participation that we have within the College of Ag. I can speak on the recruitment side. So when I go out to high schools, you know, you get a lot of questions. Ag isn't the biggest thing when it comes to high school students because it's very unknown. But just going out and explaining what we do and the opportunities that we do have, the job opportunities, the internship opportunities, the research opportunities that we do have, the things that you can contribute when it comes to agriculture into your everyday life, just being out and going and, you know, rehearsing and talking about the things that the kids can do and trying to get them to come to Southern into agriculture has been a blessing.
Okay, and that's good. And hopefully some students that want to come here, they see what you're saying as far as persistence counts. You said that when you first went to the Chancellor Dean, you didn't get an answer right then, a yes answer, but you were persistent with it. You continued to go on. This is something that you wanted to do. And that's the same thing in life. Whatever you want to do, you have to continue on with it. There's going to be some roadblocks, but you continue on if that's what you feel that you want to do in life. And so we hope other students see that, and the parents will see it and want to see that there's opportunity here at Southern University, especially in the College of Agriculture. We thank you for being a part of this program and wish you the best of luck in your endeavors.
If you love pets, then we have a segment that you won't want to miss right after the break. Welcome back. Do you love pets? And even if you don't, check this out.
Many of us love pets. Some of us are pet owners, and it is hard to think about being away from our pet any long length of time. Well, the Department of Agricultural Sciences, along with One Health, One Medicine Institute at Southern University, started what's called the SHARE program. SHARE stands for Southern Human Animal Relationship Experience. The SHARE program can help students, faculty, and staff de-stress during the semester. Deshauna Jones, an animal science student, lets us know how all of this was started.
Well, this project came into being by, I came to Dr. Marshall one day asking her if there was any research opportunities about, and if there was any with animal behaviorism, and it just so happened that she had one already in mind with the SHARE, which is a Southern University, the Southern Human-Animal Relationship Experience, and we went from there to have dog evaluations and see if the dogs were capable of being therapy animals. And now we're at the SHARE Dog Therapy, which is an initiative through the One Health, One Medicine Institute, and just bringing dogs over for the students so they can be relieved through the dogs and have less stress when it comes to classes and tests and everything that they're going through.
Reporting for the Southern University Ag Center, I'm Dexter Newman.
When we come back, Dr. Andre Johnson, Vice Chancellor for Research and Technology Development, he'll be speaking with us and sharing with us one of his latest projects that can help the community. Also, East Baton Rouge Parish Mayor President Sharon Weston Broom stopped by our Youth Chef Camp this summer to speak with them at the Ag Center. Keep it right here. We'll be back with more Focus Insight on the Southern University Ag Center. There's something new and exciting going on at the SU Ag Center. It's a new institute called SU Answers. Answers stands for air, nutrient, soils, water, ecosystems, and remote systems. They are placing air monitors around the campus. Also, a drone was donated by SU College of Ag alumnus, retired General Russell Honore. Dr. Andre Johnson, Vice Chancellor for Research and Technology Development, gives us more insight on this.
So the drones were donated by General Honore. He came to donate those to our College of Ag and Agricultural Center. The idea behind the drones is to really kind of educate our students on new technology, technology that can be used to really enhance farmers and the work that they do. Our ultimate goal is to really equip our students, but at the same time create an opportunity to help with sustainability on farm.
And get this. A $50,000 donation was made by an anonymous donor to assist with research on water pollution. The Ag Center is partnering with Apollo Water Incorporated to assist with this effort.
Thank everybody for watching this demonstration and being a part of the act of cleaning up oils and the air pollutions, the mitigation of H2S, making the environment safer. Southern University has come a long ways in science and demonstrating the research to be able to achieve the goals to clean and protect the environment.
The monitoring system will be available to the public, and it will allow for citizens to take air quality readings in their communities. The SU Ag Center welcomed East Baton Rouge Parish Mayor President Sharon Western Broom. She visited the Chef Cooking Camp. Chef stands for Creating Healthy, Enjoyable Foods. And get this. The camp was not all about cooking healthy foods. It also taught kids that exercise is needed as well.
I love the fact that Chef Camp is certainly empowering our kids and our young people with information about nutrition, about healthy living and healthy cooking. And so it's good to start with those type of with that type of information at an early age. And it becomes very obvious to me that many of these young people have a leaning towards cooking and like to cook. And so it certainly connects them with, I believe, it's one of their many passions that they have as students.
We have more Focus Insight on the Southern University Ag Center coming up right after the break. We have more Focus Insight on the Southern University Ag Center coming up right after this.
Welcome to the Southern University Livestock Show.
Southern University presented its 76th Livestock Show. This family-friendly event brought people from all across Louisiana, from spectators to participators. We spoke with Michaela Dyson, a high school senior from Tangipahoa Parish who has been showing livestock since she was 11 years old. This year, she won champion market steer.
Well, like I said, my uncle originally got me into it, and after he introduced me to it, I began to grow to love it. So it's just something that I like to do.
With such a busy schedule, Louisiana Commissioner of Agriculture, Mike Strain, finds time to visit with Southern University.
The purpose and the original purpose of livestock shows was to foster competition amongst farmers to get better livestock. And if you've seen the quality of the livestock that we have here at Southern and across Louisiana, that's been very, very, very successful. So working with extension agents and working with these 4-H and FFA projects, you know, and in a competitive but a fun environment, what happens is that it does facilitate, you know, better genetics, better quality animals, and also gets information into the hands of our young people and their families on how to raise them more efficiently, how to raise them better. But it also, you can see it's a big family affair. And so what it teaches the young people, teaches them responsibility. It also teaches them about agriculture. And it's an inner working relationship between the extension agents, you know, the university, the ag center, and the parents. And when you see these kids, you know, what's amazing, when you see them, when those kids are there with those animals, you know, you can see the competitiveness in them, but also the fact that, and you know, they love these animals and they love what they're doing.
the director of the Livestock Show, Dr. Harold Million.
So this year, as we celebrate our 76th anniversary, it's been a great show. I mean, we've had exhibitors from across the state come, all the way from North Louisiana, all the way from South Louisiana, all the way to come and share with us what they've been working on for at least the past year. So we have steers, we have pigs, we have goats and lambs, we have broilers, and all of these young people have come to show off their leadership, show off the hard work that they've put in over this short period of time just for a chance to win and show their prized animal.
These brothers from St. James were big winners in the heavyweight hog division.
I showed a medium heavyweight hog, and hard work pays off, and I learned how to get the head up.
As one grandparent from Bossier Parish, Martha Rianga, speaks highly of her grandchildren, she is proud to have supported them and her children throughout the years at the Southern University Livestock Show.
We love to come to Southern. I was coming to Southern back when Archie was in charge of the livestock division, and I'm still coming with another generation of kiddos from my family. Today, Ava had market goats, and she got first in the class with her smaller goat, and it won lightweight champion. And then her other goat was second in its class, and it ended up winning reserve champion Louisiana bred overall.
Coming to you from the M.A. Edmond Livestock Show Arena, I'm Dexter Newman reporting. Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, Nu Gamma Omega Chapter, joined in with the SU Ag Center this summer to present Design Camp for youth ages 12 to 14. Cox Communications also partnered to give away 5 Chromebooks to this year's Best Camp Designers, AKA Representative Danielle Staten.
And we are here to work with Southern University as a partnership to help support the community with our The Arts Target, which is focusing on bringing more education about the Harlem Renaissance, as well as the Black Arts Movement. And so for our fourth year, we have been reaching out to local girls in the community, and we have been partnering with seamstresses in the community to give them a valuable skill that they can use. And so they have been learning how to use t-shirts that they had at home to make a combination quilt. And today they have presented those quilts to their parents as well as to the other chapter members. And as a reward, we have a donation from Cox Communications for 5 Chromebooks, which will be given to some of the participants today. And we are so excited about the achievements of these students, and we look forward to them using these skills to further their education as well as development in their life.
The SU Ag Center's Black History Quiz Bowl is in its 25th year, and Professor Emeritus Dr. Owusu Bandele has been the program director since its inception. He explains why Black history is so important.
This is the 25th year that I've been doing the Collegiate Quiz Bowl on behalf of the Land-Grant Campus, formerly Southern University Ag Center. And the significance is this year's college quiz bowl is that we're doing it in honor of the late Dr. Raymond Lockett. His wife is coming, and we're dedicating this year to his legacy. In addition to that, we have championship rounds for both the middle school and the high schools. I've gone to 4 of the middle schools and several of the high schools. We come up with the top 2 teams, and they come here to participate in the quiz bowl. And as you can see, all the participants get a book by or about a person of African or African American descent, and the first 3 teams get medals. The level of enthusiasm has been overwhelming, particularly in the earlier grades, both the elementary and the middle. It takes a little more getting some of the college students involved, but they always come through for me.
Students from middle school, high school, and college participated in this year's quiz bowl.
For decades, there were demonstrations around the world protesting apartheid in South Africa. What was apartheid?
It was a legalized system of segregation in South Africa.
Okay. Yeah, that's correct.
I felt the need to be part of this Black History Quiz Bowl because I think there's actually some very interesting history that a lot of people don't know about. And I thought it's a good opportunity to learn about some of that history.
Black history is not only important, but it's part of American history. And I think as citizens of America, and especially being a black female, it's very important to remember our history and to honor it, especially during February, Black History Month.
The Embassy of Africa made a visit to Southern University College of Ag to facilitate a research and technology partnership with Southern University and to bring South African students pursuing master's and PhDs for the exchange program. Professor Jean Bailey, Human Development at Howard University.
I have been working with the Embassy of South Africa, Ms. Janetha Mashlangu, to help to facilitate the Southern University Ag program and the College of Agricultural and Family and Consumer Sciences partnership with the Department of Agricultural, Forestry and Fisheries for South Africa, as well as their Agricultural Research Center.
Janetha Malangu, Minister of Agriculture, South African Embassy, United States.
Responsible for promoting trade, investment, technology, cooperation, and research with the United States of America. And the reason that I'm here, we are planning on having a research and technology partnership with the Southern University, whereby we can bring our masters, South African masters and PhD students for exchange program studying, as well as sharing experiences on best practices between South Africa and the University of the Southern University.
Before we go today, we'd like to recognize someone for all the work that they've done in broadcast media. We're speaking of legendary radio personality and TV host Guy Brody. If it wasn't for Guy Brody, I probably wouldn't be in broadcasting today, and so many others that are in this field of work.
You know, every 33 minutes, someone dies in an alcohol-related accident. It's the second most violent crime in America. Don't drive and drink. You drink, you drive, you lose.
This public service announcement was brought to you by the SU Ag Center.
Hi, I'm Dr. Brody. I'm not a real doctor. I play one on the radio. You know, they have free health care screenings. Come on out. Jambalaya, hot dogs for the kids. Just a big, fun time.
Guy Brody has worked with Southern University Ag Center on several occasions, one being a Hurricane Katrina documentary where he was on-camera talent.
27 days after Hurricane Katrina, while families were being scattered and separated, while the local, state, and federal government officials were addressing the growing problems of displacement and human suffering, the unthinkable happened. Hurricane Rita hit the state.
This chair kind of rocks a little bit.
Whenever you're ready, guy.
All right. One steadfast lesson learned from the 2005 storms that policymakers and families had agreed on is that individual emergency plans must interlink with the local, city, and state plans in order to better save lives and preserve Louisiana citizenry.
At this point, we'd like to send out a big thank you to Guy Brody for all you've done in broadcast media. Well, this concludes another edition of Focus, Insight on the Southern University Ag Center. If there's something that you would like to view again, you can watch it in its entirety on our YouTube channel, SU Ag Center. And also, for contact information, go to our website at suagcenter.com. And while you're there, check out all of our social media platforms. Always in parting, we like to close the program the way that I was taught in Sunday school. We would say, may the Lord watch between me and thee, while we're absent one from another. You know the rest. And from all of us here at the Southern University Ag Center and the College of Agriculture, Family, and Consumer Sciences, take care. Thanks for watching Focus, Insight on the Southern University Ag Center. This is a statewide and beyond digital media production.
Temptations. Lady Soul on the Guy Brody Show.